Tell us about your show.
Well, this was a show of my most recent work. The majority of the work is from the past 3 to 4 months. It's titled Disintegration, which kind of follows along a theme I've been thinking about over the past year or so. And it's mostly single figures, portraits, and incorporates a couple prints, etchings, and it's actually in conjunction with Jean-Jacques Poré, who's a friend and artist from Chicago, Illinois. Putting the shows together is finding work that has a common thread that makes the work have a synergy or somehow work together to complement one another. I think that's sort of the trick in putting, you know, shows together, group shows, and even two-person shows, is finding that synergy between the two works. And that's a fun task for a gallery.
In the paintings in this show, just literally, they're all mixed media. That's acrylic.
It's acrylic, oil, enamel, primarily. There's charcoal, pastel. It's mostly those five mediums. The paintings are actually all sort of, I consider them fragments of time. They're memories. They start with the concept of that memory and eventually kind of become their own element. I usually start with that kind of a concept. That's where the text comes in. It doubles kind of as a working aid for you know, a stream of consciousness when you're thinking about things from the past, and it helps pull you into that moment of time. And it also becomes, you know, part of the space in which the figure is kept. A lot of times, you know, the spatial considerations have to do with pictorial elements. In my paintings, the spaces that the figures are contained within are more psychological types of spaces. So each actual painting starts with a thought or a memory of a person that was close to me, or a lot of times things about myself, and at some point the process takes over and a form of intuition sort of takes over, and it becomes, you know, a little bit larger than that, in the sense that it kind of has its own life. It becomes its own moment in time as the painting is happening. So that's kind of the idea about the stories. There's no real straight narrative, but it's more comes from the idea of my past. The figure on the left is it's sort of a literal translation of the way that we are overwhelmed by information. This idea of disintegration, having to do with the space, having to do with the psychological elements that is also in the painting. It's a push and pull, and I don't dictate that. A lot of that comes from the process. A lot of that comes from actually just the painting, the mark making, the materials, the use of materials. And so that painting has gone through a lot of changes, coming forward and backwards with the roles reversing on that. Two individuals, and I get a lot more information in a piece where there's more than one figure, but it kind of separates itself from my idea of like a perfect painting and what a painting, the idea of a portrait or an icon or a symbol sometimes isn't as clear when there's more than one figure, but the dialogue gets a lot greater and the amount of information that can go into the piece becomes a lot greater.
Who have been some of the influences in your artistic career?
It's varied over a long period of time. you know, I drew a lot of inspiration from early periods, the High Renaissance period, as I was developing my own artwork. But I would say over studying a large number of artists, the abstract expressionist really rang true to my concept of painting. The Bay Area artists are another really strong period of figurative work that really used a lot of the expressionism from the abstract expressionists. Jacques Ametti was also a very big influence in this time period of my work. As we talked earlier, Francis Bacon. In the same aspect, I would say that life itself, what you see in life, what you experience in life, is as influential as art history, art historical references. I mean, it's really, at some point, life kind of takes over the inspiration, and that's really what I draw the most on in this work. You know, as far as the psychological space in these paintings, a big shift in my work was from the idea of space and the translation of a pictorial space into what I felt to be a more psychological space, and where the text comes in and really brings you to the surface, the use of sands, the use of the textures from metal, the ideas of structure, man-made structure versus, you know, the human, the fragile human. You know, those kind of ideas really are germinating in this work, and I think it's real important that kind of space is understood as a very important element to my concept of what painting is. So I think that's about it.